Let me tell you, buddy, there's a faster gun coming over yonder when tomorrow comes. Let me tell you, buddy, and it won't be long till you find yourself singing your last cowboy song.
Yippee-ki-yay, when the roundup ends. Yippee-ki-yay, and the campfire dims. Yippee-ki-yay, he shouts and he sings. When a cowboy trades his spurs for wings.
So with the smaller ducks like the teal, normally just breast them out. It's easier. Not a lot of meat on them compared to the mallard size. So best way to do that is just kind of peel this back. And I like to do this over a trash can if you have one. So yeah, just peel it back with your thumbs. Expose the breast meat. You can see that. Okay. And then once you have that, you're looking at it, right? Once you have all the breast meat exposed, peel it back all the way to the wings. Then you take your thumb and put your thumb underneath the breastplate here and just press that in there like that. Then you peel it back, exposing the internal organs. And then I also like to take this finger and go through the top like that. And then grab it by the neck and peel back. All right. Once you got it peeled back, and you lift this up a little bit more, you can see the heart in there. Here's the heart. It's right inside there, right underneath the rib cage. Peel this out. Yeah, it doesn't matter. So anyways, after you peel that back, pull that back a little bit, I just rip that all the way back down. And the only thing you have left after you've done that is the wings. See, cleaned out the backside. And this is how you're supposed to transport them, unless you transport them whole. And I just take the clippers, get it right underneath the wing, clip that off, throw them away. You can use those for training dogs later on if you want, but yeah, just clip that, throw it down. All right, so we got the teal breast, and then teal heart, and then a liver there. We got a hungry Stella in the corner. I don't know if you could see her, but she loves the duck hearts. So we're just gonna tilt her back and then drop it, and she eats it. She loves them. Let's see if she likes the liver as well. Yep. She liked that as well. Should look something like that when they're finished. Got two legs from the mallard, the breast from the mallard, and then the breast from the teal, and the heart from the mallard. Stella, normally if I have like a bunch of these, I'll cook them up, but Stella like absolutely loves them. So here she is, sit. Yeah.
It's like a reward.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to another amazing episode of Cooking with Ali. Today we have something very special for you. We have three different types of birds of wild game, and we're going to show you how to marinate them, and we'll cook them once later tonight. But first things first, let's get started with a nice Colorado Kool-Aid. That's right. Yellow jacket, yellow belly, whatever you want to call it. And then we have a shot from Arizona's finest whiskey. Oh, whoo! Not the best whiskey I've ever had. But hey, go down to Arizona, bring back a bottle of whiskey.
Try that out. Alrighty, so what we have here are two dove breasts. I've breasted most of them. This is a Eurasian dove. It's a morning dove. Notice how the Eurasian's larger. Then we have two teal, one that I got today, one from a while back, breasted some of those as well. And then the mallard that you saw me plucking earlier, that's the whole breast there with the skin on. An old mallard from a while ago, breasted that one, and then of course, the two drumsticks. Alrighty, so I'm gonna show you how to breast these really quick. It's pretty simple. You just take your knife, slice right down the center. There's a little bone plate there and you just wanna peel the meat back. Just notice how I'm peeling it back with the knife, then cut it off at the edge. There. Same thing with this side. Gotta be fast here. And then peel it back, cut it off at the edge. Set that aside. Put that in your pile. For the marinade, it's pretty simple. It's from Martha Stewart. It's her spicy hoisin marinade. Google it. Martha Stewart holding it down, smoking weed with Snoop Dogg. It's fantastic. Okay, so take your stuff, leave it after it's all cut up and prepared. You want a bowl with a little bit of grated ginger in there. I only had a little bit. You need a little bit more. You can always use dry ground ginger, but go easy on it. Don't use a ton. That actually isn't even going to fit. Just do like a half tablespoon of this. Throw that in there. Always do your dry ingredients first. So ginger, dried ground ginger and freshly grated ginger. You don't need a ton, but yeah. Put that in there and go ahead and put your quarter cup of brown sugar, quarter cup of soy sauce, some garlic cloves as well. Just gotta know how to work this device. Holy shit! Okay, here we go. Yeah, get those garlic cloves in there. I said about two on the recipe, but I just did like three little ones. And then make sure not to cut the metal, because wife gets mad if you cut the metal with the Cutco knives. Gotta keep these Cutco knives sharp. You sell it, by the way. Okay, so that's in there. Next, you wanna do a little bit of mustard. Full tablespoon mustard. Fuck. There's one or half, and then there's your four. Okay. If you got your mustard, you want to do only maybe a teaspoon of the peppers. Not too much. Oh, that's a little bit more. That's all right. Put that in there. And then it says orange juice. I don't have orange juice, so I'm using lemon juice. And you want 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. Should be orange, but lemon will work too. It also says orange zest. Yeah. Don't have a fucking orange. Live in Colorado. No goddamn orange trees out here in Colorado. Alright? I'm sorry, but that's just what you gotta deal with. Okay? You don't have your beautiful citrus tree just hanging out. Okay, sherry vinegar or rice wine vinegar will work as well. 2 tablespoons of that. 1, 2. And then here is the kicker. Hoisin sauce. Go to your local Asian market. Or get it on Amazon or wherever. Get some fucking hoisin. And you want 2 tablespoons of hoisin as well. And you don't be shy with the hoisin. The hoisin is pretty good, man. It's pretty good. And then, that's pretty much it. Okay, once you got all that, go ahead and start grabbing all your dove breasts. Oh wait, no, you gotta mix it up. Shit, my hands are dirty. Whisk it all up. Make sure you dissolve a lot of that brown sugar and get all your dry ingredients mixed well with your wet ingredients. You might have to double this, guys. There is not a lot in there. Actually, no, there's quite a bit. Okay, so once it looks like that, take all your dove breasts, throw them in. Same with your teal breasts, throw those in. And then your mallard breasts, mallard legs, and I'm just doing the full mallard breast. Put that all in there. Make sure it gets covered. Everything is covered. Should look something like that once it's all covered. Get a little thing to place on top. And then put it in the fridge. Go shoot some guns for a while. Watch some football. Then we'll show you how to throw it on the grill just here in a second. You're gonna like the way it tastes, I guarantee it. And remember, here on Cooking with Ali, we're always cooking with the best ingredients, the best food for you, with you in mind. Cheers. We'll see you in a little bit. Give me a break. This is too good. Look at it. Everything's marinated. Some of the stuff has been bacon wrapped. Some of it hasn't. Jalapenos, green chilies, bell peppers. We got bacon wrapped banana peppers. Nobody knows why, but one thing we do know, this is delicious. Look at this. We're gonna grill a lot of this. We're gonna try some of it in the air fryer. We got a bunch of leftover, still in the marinade. Save that for another time. Don't have to cook it all at once, because when you reheat it in the microwave, it's not gonna be as good. Get it through your skin. Before I get to grilling and air frying these delicious ducks and doves, do a quick black jalapeno test. Yeah, I'm fine. Totally fine. Ready? I'm back. My mind was shutting down from that jalapeno, that black jalapeno. I don't recommend black jalapenos. But let me show you what we're working with here. This plate's all going on the grill. This is all going in the air fryer. Good assortment here. Grilled, air fried.